So continue our next point of the chapter of bioavailability and bioequivalence, that is measurement of bioavailability or their method of assessment of bioavailability. So what is next point? Measurement of bioavailability or methods of assessment of bioavailability. So in this, there are two important methods which are used for assessment of this bioavailability. So first method, that is indirect methods, and second will be the direct method. So in the indirect method, which is also known as a pharmacokinetic method. So in the indirect method, so the bioavailability first will be assessed or measured from this human plasma data, or this is plasma concentration time profiles. So in this human plasma data, they are divided into the 3 points or subdivided into 3 points. First, the peak plasma drug concentration, that is Cmax. Second, time of ultimate plasma concentration, or time of maximum plasma concentration, time at maximum plasma concentration, which is called as the Tmax. And third will be the area under the curve. So this is the in the first method, that is indirect method. There are two types of method. First is the data from human plasma data which is a bioavailability assessment or measure from human plasma data, and also from urinary excretion data. So in this human plasma data, there are three: peak plasma drug concentration, second time of ultimate plasma concentration, or which is called a Tmax, and last will be the area under the curve. So first, peak plasma drug concentration, or which is called as a Cmax. So this peak plasma concentration, which is obtained from the extravascular administration of the drug product. So this peak plasma concentration we obtain from extravascular administration of any drug or their dosage form, and the collection of the blood sample at predetermined time interval from the human body, and it will be measured the drug concentration at each time interval. So after administration of this drug on through the extravascular route, the blood sample will be collected at predetermined the time interval from the human body, and the measure the drug concentration at each time of interval. The concentration of drug in each time, or blood sample which is determined, which is suitable assay technique, or is concentration of the drug in each time in the blood sample, which will be determined the suitable assay technique, example HPLC method. So from using this technique, these concentration are expressed in microgram per ml or nanogram per ml, is plotted using graph paper with respect to time. So the concentration of the drug in each time in the blood sample, which will be determined using assay technique, example HPLC methods. So the concentration will be expressed into the microgram per ml or nanogram per ml. From this data, we plotted the graph using data. This data, which is plotted on the graph paper with respect to time. So the point of concentration of the drug maximum in the plasma, the point of concentration of the drug maximum in the plasma, म्हणजे अशा पॉइंटच्या वेळी जेव्हा प्लाझ्मामध्ये ड्रग्सचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन मॅक्सिमस असतं, किंवा असा पॉइंट ज्यावेळी ड्रग्सचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन मॅक्सिमम असतं प्लाझ्मामध्ये, विच इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ पीक ऑर मॅक्सिमम ड्रग कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन. सो विच इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ पीक प्लाझ्मा कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन, ऑर विच इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ ड्रग ऑर मॅक्सिमम ड्रग कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन, ऑर विच इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ Cmax. सो ॲट दिस ग्राफ, द प्लॉटेड द ग्राफ अकॉर्डिंग टू द plasma concentration of drug versus time profile. So at this point, that is Cmax, where at this point the drug concentration will be maximum in the plasma. So which is this point, which is called as a peak plasma concentration. From this drug level curve, we can judge the drug concentration in the plasma within a therapeutic level or toxic level. So from this data or from this drug curve, from this graph, we judge the concentration of drug plasma within a therapeutic level or any toxic level. So next will be the Tmax, the time of ultimate plasma, the peak time of ultimate plasma concentration. So this time to take and reach ultimate plasma concentration after oral administration, which is known as the time of peak plasma concentration, which is called a Tmax. म्हणजे अशा वेळी जेव्हा एखाद्या ड्रगचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन हे हायर असतं किंवा पीक प्लाझ्मा कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन असतं त्या टायमिंगला किंवा त्या टाइमला काय म्हणतात टाइम ऑफ पीक प्लाझ्मा कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑर विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ टी मॅक्स. सो एखादा ड्रग ऍडमिनिस्टर थ्रू द एक्स्ट्रा वॅस्क्युलर रूटने आपण ऍडमिनिस्टर किंवा वन्स अ ड्रग विल बी ऍडमिनिस्टर थ्रू द एक्स्ट्रा वॅस्क्युलर रूट दॅट टाइम द कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ द ड्रग इन द प्लाझ्मा विल बी हाय ऑर मॅक्सिमम दिस टाइम विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ Tmax or time of ultimate plasma concentration. So the Tmax will be expressed in hours or minute on from this Tmax onset of action or onset of time are estimated, which is estimated by the based upon the rate of absorption. So from this Tmax we estimate the onset of action or onset of time, which is based upon the rate of absorption. So this is the second. So at this point, that is the Tmax. This is the Tmax where the plasma concentration of the drug into the plasma concentration will be maximum. So that time, which is called as the Tmax. Next, area under the curve. Next point, that is area under the curve. So what is area under the curve? That is also known as which is AUC. Short form is AUC. The total integrated area. What is area under the curve? The total integrated area under the plasma drug concentration and time profile. The total integrated area is to under this plasma concentration versus time profile. त्याला काय म्हणतात एरिया अंडर द कर्व. सो इट इज युजफुल टू एस्टिमेट द टोटल अमाउंट ऑर एक्सटेंड अमाउंट ऑफ ड्रग विच एंटर इन टू द सिस्टमिक सर्क्युलेशन. या एरिया अंडर द कर्व काय डिनोट करतं किंवा इट इज युजफुल फॉर एस्टिमेशन ऑफ द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ द ड्रग ऑर एक्सटेंड ऑफ द ड्रग विच आर एंटर इन टू द सिस्टमिक सर्क्युलेशन. अँड इज एरिया अंडर द कर्व विच इज एस्टिमेटेड इन मायक्रोग्राम पर एम एल ऑर नॅनोग्राम पर एम एल. And it is one of the significant parameters to consider for estimating the bioavailability. So this area under the curve, which is significant parameter for considering the estimation or measuring the bioavailability. So there are four methods which are existing for determination of this AUC or area under the curve of the plasma concentration versus time profile. So there are four important methods which are used for determination of this area under the curve. So first method, that is use of planimeter. Second count square method. Third will be the trapezoidal rule, and last will be the cutting and weighing of the methods. So these are the first methods. Indirect methods from this there is the assessment of this bioavailability or measurement of this bioavailability of the drug. So that is from the human plasma concentration or from the plasma concentration time profile. So next method which is from urinary excretion data. So first method, indirect method, that is or pharmacokinetic method from the data from available from this human plasma concept, human plasma data. Second will be from the urinary excretion. Second method will be the from the urinary excretion data. So this urinary excretion excretion of the unchanged drug, which is directly comparable to the unchanged plasma drug concentration. So this urinary excretion of unchanged drug, which is directly comparable to this plasma drug concentration, where unchanged drug will be excreted in the urine, so which is comparable or comparable with unchanged with plasma drug concentration. So this urine excretion data is based upon this data, which is based upon excreted drug in the urine. So the data is based upon drug will be excreted in the urine, and viability from this the drug will be excreted in urine, the viability can be determined. So from this drug will be excreted in urine, the viability can be determined. This method to estimate the unchanged drug from the urine. So the urine excretion data, which is important for method for estimation of this unchanged drug from the urine. So for this, there is a collection of urine at a specified intervals for a time span. So for estimation of the unchanged drug in the urine, there is a collection of urine at specified time interval, or which is time period or time span, which is equivalent to the 7 biological half-life. So jevda data collection hoto fakt urine madla unchanged drug kiwa tithe estimation karna ahe, which is equivalent to 7 biological half-life, and unchanged drug which are present in each interval which is collected. So unchanged drug will be which are present into the present in the collection or urine which is collected and which is analyzed, the cumulative drug content is excreted. So pratyek interval la jevde kevde spine time span madhe jevde collection hoil unchanged drug which are collected and then will be analyzed, the cumulative drug will be excreted into this urine. So there is a graphical representation of urinary excretion rate versus time profile, so which are shown in the figure. So first, this is the collection of urinary collection period, and this is the rate of excretion. So in this, there is important graph. So first will be the maximum urinary excretion data. So first method in this, maximum urinary excretion data, that is DXU/DT. So the maximum urinary rate increases when the rate and extent amount of the drug absorption will be increased in the blood. Jeva urinary rate increases hoto, jo maximum rate increase hoto, teva kay hota, rate of amount of the drug will be absorbed will be in the blood will be increases. So rate of excretion of the unchanged drug in the urine generally follows. So rate of excretion of the unchanged drug, ekhada drug cha rate of excretion of ekhada urine madhe, which is generally this will be follows first order process. The plot which is obtained by urinary rate versus time at the midpoint of the urine collection, so which is called as a maximum point. So this point called as a maximum urinary rate of excretion. So that is maximum point in which DXU, that is maximum urinary excretion, which is used to estimate the bioavailability of the product. Next will be the time for maximum excretion. So similar like plasma time at which the plasma concentration will be high, into the peak plasma concentration will be high, or that time interval where the peak plasma concentration high, which is called as the Tmax. So similarly, the time for the maximum excretion, the time at which where the maximum excretion of the drug into the urine, which is called as the Tumax. That is, Tu means the rate of the time of excretion which is had, the concentration of the drug excrete will be maximum. It is the time at which maximum urinary excretion rate. So time at which maximum urinary excretion rate, and it will be decreased the absorption rate. It will be decreased the absorption rate will be. So it decreases as absorption rate will be. So this maximum rate will be decreased with absorption rate will be decreases, and it is analogs to the Tmax plasma level data. So it is, so similarly, it is analog it is similar to the Tmax plasma level data. So the Tmax maximum in the urinary or time at which which is maximum excretion rate, which is called as the Tmax, and it will be decreases, the absorption rate will be decreases. So this Tmax, Tmax will be decreases with absorption rate will be decreases, and it is analog to the T plasma, Tmax plasma level data. Next point, that is cumulative extent of the drug excreted in the urine. So X will be, that is next from the bioavailability will be considered, bioavailability will be measured from this cumulative extent of the drug will be excreted in the urine. That is X is X infinity U. So the cumulative extent of the drug will be excreted in the urine correspondent to the X infinity in the urinary. It is directly proportional to the, or cumulative extent of the drug will be excreted in the urine, which is directly proportional to the amount or extent of the drug will be absorbed. So ekhada drug cha cumulative extent, kiwa drug kiti cumulative extent madhe excreted hote urine madhe, which is directly proportional to the amount of the drug will be extended, or amount of the drug will be absorbed. So excretion of the drug into urine continues till the drug level in the blood falls to the zero. So this excretion of the drug in the urine, which continues until the drug level in the blood which falls, or it's completely zero. So parent plasma madli kiwa blood madle jo parent drug chi level zero hot nahi to parent kay hoto, the excretion of the drug will be continued. Using the value of bioavailability, so using this cumulative extent drug excreted in the urine data, we calculate our bioavailability can be estimated. So amount of the bioavailability, which is calculated from these two equations, the amount of the bioavailability can be calculated from the equation. So first, for single dose study, so first bioavailability can be estimated from single dose study. The F is equal to XU, that is urinary excretion of oral, multiplied by dose of IV divided by excretion of the drug, cumulative excretion of the drug into the urine by IV multiplied by dose of oral. So similarly, FR, this is renal excretion. So for relative, so first is the absolute bioavailability, second FR means relative bioavailability. So where urinary excretion, that is XU into the taste, excretion of the drug into the, or cumulative excretion of the dose into taste, multiplied by dose of standard divided by XU into standard of dose of the taste. So similar for multiple dose study, the FR, the relative bioavailability, is equal to XU into the taste, that is maximum concentration of the drug into the plasma, that is dose, next we multiply by dose of standard, multiply by T taste, that is T max of the taste, and divided by XU standard, multiply by D taste into the T standard. So this is the for calculating the bioavailability for single dose study or for multiple dose study. So this is the method, these are the methods which are used for the indirect method, which is used for the measuring or assessment of bioavailability. So these are the equations which are used for mainly calculating for this single dose study or for multiple study. Their bioavailability from this equation will be calculated. So F will be the absolute bioavailability, FR means the relative bioavailability, XU is the urinary excretion or maximum urinary excretion of the drug, and D means the dose of the drug, T will be the taste. Okay, so this is a indirect methods which is used for the assessment of bioavailability. Next are the pharmacodynamic or direct methods. So This method, which is second method for assessment, which is called as the pharmacodynamic method, or which is called as the direct methods. So these pharmacodynamic methods are utilized to assess the viability when it is difficult to assess the viability by the pharmacokinetic method or lack of sensitive analytic method. So केव्हा आपण यूज करतो फायनल फार्माकोडायनामिक और डायरेक्ट मेथड वेन द असेसमेंट और मेजरिंग बायोलॉजी फ्रॉम दिस फार्माकोडायनामिक मेथड और फ्रॉम द लेस और लॅक सेन्सिटिव्ह एनालिटिक मेथड जेव्हा आपल्याला करता येत नाही फार्माकोडायनामिक और फार्माकोकायनेटिक मेथडने जर आपल्याला बायोलॉजी असेस किंवा मेजर करता येत नाही किंवा एखादी लॅक ऑफ सेन्सिटिव्ह एनालिटिक मेथड असते त्याच्यावर जर असेस करता येत नाही त्यावेळी फार्माकोडायनामिक मेथड किंवा डायरेक्ट मेथड आपण युटिलाइज करतो. सो देर आर टू फार्माकोडायनामिक मेथड विच इज यूज फॉर डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ बायोअवेलेबिलिटी. सो फर्स्ट विल बी द अक्यूट फार्माकोलॉजिकल रिस्पॉन्स अँड सेकंड विल बी द क्लिनिकल रिस्पॉन्स. सो दीज आर द टू फार्माकोडायनामिक मेथड फॉर असेसमेंट ऑफ viability or determination of viability. First acute pharmacological response, second will be the clinical response. So first will be the acute pharmacological response. It is easily measured the pharmacological response method are EEG, heart rate, ECG, BP, pupil diameter, etc. So this acute pharmacological response method easily measure the pharmacological response method. Response methods are EEG, heart rate, ECG, BP, blood pressure, pupil diameter. The viability can be determined the plotting pharmacological effect versus time curve. So this viability can be determined using pharmacological effect versus time curve along with the dose response graph. The disadvantage of this technique is it is a more inconstant. This technique will be the more inconstant and the acute linear relationship between the observed pharmacological response and versus drug level is difficult to the access. So the data which is obtained from this acute the data which is obtained by using this method which is not more constant, so there will be the difficulty to access this viability from this pharmacological response versus drug level or drug concentration. So this is the first method which is called as the acute pharmacological response. Next method direct method is the clinical response. So by using this clinical response we directly observe. So from this clinical response we observe the directly the therapeutic effects of the dosage form after any administration. So ekhada therapeutic effect kutla dose drug secure dosage forms hai he administer through this or we observe through this clinical response method. Je ekhada jar dose apan administer kela therapeutic directly the therapeutic effects of the dosage form after administration je kutlyahi drug cha direct kutla effect therapeutic effect milto हे आपण ऑब्झर्व विच इज ऑब्झर्व बाय युझिंग दिस क्लिनिकल रिस्पॉन्स. प्रॅक्टिकली इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू द प्रेडिक्ट द बायोअवेलेबिलिटी ऍज रिझल्ट ऑफ डिफरन्स बोथ फार्माकोकायनेटिक अँड फार्माकोडायनामिक बिहेवियर ऑफ द ड्रग अमॉंग द इंडिव्हिज्युअल. सो दे बाय युझिंग दिस क्लिनिकल रिस्पॉन्स देर इज अ प्रॅक्टिकली डिफिकल्टी टू प्रेडिक्ट बायोअवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ बिटवीन रिझल्ट बिटवीन दिस डिफरन्स बिटवीन दिस फार्माकोकायनेटिक मेथड और फार्माकोडायनामिक बिहेवियर ऑफ द drug among the individual. Magic this pharmacokinetic method shows different viability or different viability data or this pharmacokinetic shows different. So there is a practically difficulty to predict viability from this result or difference in the pharmacokinetic and the pharmacodynamic behavior of this drug among the individual. So there are number of factors which will be affect pharmacodynamic drug behavior. So you know, for any absorption distribution protein binding or this excretion of the drug will be affect on the this concentration will be drug will be affect. So similarly the viability also change due to this number of factors. So mainly, the number of factors which are affecting pharmacodynamic drug behavior can include drug tolerance, their age of the patient or individuals, drug addictions, drug interaction, and unknown pathophysiological factors which will be affect this data, that is, or this method, that is clinical response. Okay, so these are the various methods which are assessed bioavailability of the drug, or these methods which are used for the measurement of this bioavailability. So we stop here. Next point we study in the next lecture.